So look forward to that. And our next performer is someone I've known for a very long time. We worked together in the early 80s in a number of disreputable poetry organisations, Tongue Circus and Worthless Words being two of them. He's performed in many other shows with I've been involved in over the years, in festivals in Cornwall and elsewhere. And suffice to say, he is here tonight. Please put your hands together for the fantastic P.R. Murray.
Thank you, Patrick. I'm P.R. Murray. I come from Dollis Hill, which is in North London. When the President of America visits, his helicopters fly over my house. When the President's helicopters fly over, when the ruler of the world comes to London and his iron chariots thunder up in the red night skies, he slices air with the rotors, my semi-detached residence trembles vole-like beneath him. I didn't respect him, I didn't elect him, I don't want him, and I didn't invite him. But when a convoy of Chinooks and other associated night-riding heli-hags slice across ordinary North London suburban air, I'm down with the people in Dollis Hill, shaking in my boots whether I want to or not. And a splash of coffee leaks from my cup with what could be shock or could be awe. My beverage may wish to grovel on the floor, but I do not. I do a genre of poems which is called the I Am poems. I am the compost, I rot in a heap, I rot when you wake, I rot when you sleep. I have no body nor brain instead, I am the living that lives on the dead. Potato peelings, garden cuttings and tea bags, or a philosopher's head wrapped up in a sack. It all came from compost, I bring it back. All organic transform, that's what I do. I am the compost, sin you'll be too. Right, and this one could be just somehow influenced by William Blake. I am a tiger burning bright in the forest of the night, or in the day and in the shade, lying watching in a glade where the golden light is striping down through green foliage and leaves me almost invisible except for my unblinking eye, which only the dying should see. I am a tiger, and I once heard a philosopher teaching. He said, philosophy is like searching for a black cat in a darkened room at night with a brown paper bag over your head. It is totally out of court, it is just not cricket. I thought this did not concern me because I am a tiger and not a black panther. But lest some roving forest gypsy passing by with a handmade flintlock gun made out of an old gas pipe should descry my unblinking eye and shoot me through it in order to sell my powerful powdered penis to give another Chinese millionaire a hard-on that he doesn't really need, I stir myself and pad out across the jungle floor. Yes, I think I'll eat a philosopher tonight. Not the back of his head with one swipe of my paw. Lick all the knowledge porridge out of his skull with my abrasive tongue, and then I might know what he was talking about. Or I could, like my northern brothers up in the snow, go for a Siberian. But that might just like be drinking a gallon of vodka. Okay. A political poem, some of you may get the reference, but I'm not actually an anarchist, but this is the kind of thing that makes me wish I was. Waking up in wet November, crawling into clothes, crawling into types of transport to take me where I don't want to go, to spend a day doing what I don't want to do, that is depressing, or hearing on the radio early in the morning stating the date when the day is the day of the exam, or when the dentist will drill your gob down to the nerve, or the day when the bill hits the doormat, or the day when the shit hits the fan. But nothing is more depressing than hearing a crowd enthusiastically applauding a leader's speech. I'd rather be a shepherd stuck up some Celtic ship pile in the rain, listening to the bleeding sheep bleeding, bleating again and again and again, than ever have my oral orifice offended by the happy clappiness of humans surrendering their humanity to some blonde political fantasy. Oh, leader, leader, take it all away. Take us up to heaven today, to where sweet sky pie is free and we never pay. And all our headaches have gone away, because all our thinking is over and done. It's all over, because you are the one who bathes us in smiliness like the sun. So clap, 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 you vacuous creeps. Your public grovelling makes me weak. Smack me up, send me back to sleep. I'd rather die and rot and feed a tree, because political compost is what I'd rather be than ever follow a leader. Right, I think I do have maybe a couple about economics, about find the bloody thing.
Economics.
Spinning ones. Tonight. Where's the economics ones? Oh, well, I'll just do one about economics then. This is Adam Smith's sock problem. Okay. Sock, 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 emergency. There are no socks upon my feet. There are no socks that I can see. So I seek socks immediately. I woke up in the morning, birds are singing in the tree, but I see toes in front of me. So I seek socks with urgency. Sock, 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 emergency. There are no socks upon my feet. There are no socks that I can see. Sock, sock, socks, immediately. My socks are vermin dirty or my socks are soaking wet. But I've got to wear them or go barefoot. I've got to mark absence of hosiery. Sock, 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 emergency. There are no socks upon my feet. There are no socks that I can see. Sock, sock, socks, immediately. But am I going to sit here till my feet grow fur? No, I'm going to get up and get going and be a sock entrepreneur. Sock, 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 emergency. There are no socks upon my feet. There are no socks that I can see. So I'm going to start a sock factory. I'm going to raise some capital, going to go it alone. Get them third world kids knitting in a free trade zone. Sock, 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 emergency. There are no socks upon my feet. There are no socks that I can see. Make more socks immediately. Now I've started moving, I ain't going to stop like a shark in the water. I keep swimming or I drop. I won't let anyone else make any socks. Yes, it's sock, 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 emergency. You all got to buy your socks from me, because I've wiped out all competition. So now you see, I've got a sock, sock, sock monopoly. Yeah. I think now is the time, in the light of the heroic action by the French fishermen, to end with the marching song of the Lobster Liberation Front for this half. Find that, wherever it is. And there when you want it. Yes, here it is. Listen, people, don't eat lobsters. You never know where they have been. They have crawled underneath seas and seen things you've never seen. Listen, people, don't eat lobsters. You never know where they have been. They've seen sharks having a laugh. They've seen the big squid having fun. And they have learned from schools of mackerel beneath the light of a watery sun. Yes, these crustaceans got deep emotions as they crawl on ocean floors. Lobsters have codes, lobsters transmit, lobsters kiss with their strong sharp claws. So now people don't eat real lobsters, just feast your eyes on the plastic lobsters hanging from the Tudor beam. Let the real ones live contented, seeing things you've never seen.
That was P.R. Murray giving us some sock and awe. More applause, please.